last video, I showed you 6 accessories you could get for your Brompton. Some of those really make your ride more convenient, but still cost you some money. Today, I'll do something a bit different and share 10 Brompton hacks that will make your life easier for free. Most of them you can do with supplies you probably already have at home. When going for a bike ride, people usually carry a pack of tools in case they get a flat tire or the brakes run out of adjustment. These packs usually consist of tire levers, a patch kit, an extra tube, a pump, a multi-tool, and some cash. Carrying this tool bag every time you go out for a ride can be quite inconvenient. But well, you don't need that on the Brompton. This bike has an air pump that sits attached to the rear triangle and a toolkit that's stored inside of the bike frame. The only piece that's missing here is an extra inner tube. We can, however, store a spare tube on the other side of the top tube. To do that, first grab a new Brompton inner tube and remove it from its packaging. We're gonna have to fold it in half, but we do not want to do it like this. We want to keep it laterally symmetric when it's folded, so the result should look something like this. Make sure you keep the valve pointing straight out, not to the side. Then use some PVC film you may already have in your kitchen to press it as tight as possible. It may help to have an extra pair of hands here if anyone is around to assist you. Once you're done with that, use some tape to prevent the film from unrolling. Finally, we're going to insert it into the bike frame. Notice how the inner tube has a curvature that kind of matches the curvature on the frame. This is the orientation that we want to insert it into the top tube. If we flip it vertically, the curvature of the inner tube will not match the curvature of the frame, and the inner tube can get stuck in there. Now, insert the tube into the bike with the valve pointing outwards. If you're afraid the tube will slide all the way in and get stuck in there, you can also use a string to connect it to the bolt clamp, like this. This will prevent the tube from going too deep into the bike frame. I personally don't use a string myself, since I can just tilt the bike and the valve will stick right out. The inner tube actually slides quite easily inside of the bike frame if you tilt the bike back and forth. You may be concerned about the inner tube getting damaged, but it hasn't happened to me, and my last inner tube was in perfect condition after over a year of being capped inside of the frame just like this. The second hack is for those of you who don't own the Brompton toolkit and are willing to accept an improvised solution. Just grab 2 tire levers, a cheap small multi-tool, a patch kit, and a small Ziploc bag. Put everything in the Ziploc bag as tight as possible. Now, put it in the front portion of the frame, where the original Brompton toolkit would go. Keep in mind that it may fall out while transporting the bike with the frame open. You can use a piece of electrical tape to prevent the tools from falling out. It doesn't look all that good, but, well, you've got yourself a hack. Since we're talking about storing stuff inside of the bike, there's a bit more we can do. Zip ties can come quite handy when improvising solutions on the bike. And so is some duct tape and some electrical tape. So let's keep them in the bike as well. Grab an old pen you won't need anymore, remove the cap and also the cartridge. Now, wrap some tape around it. You can use different kinds of tape if you want. For example, I'm using duct tape and also some electrical tape. If you ever need a piece while on the road, you just have to unroll the amount you need. You can also stick some zip ties in it. Again, put everything in a Ziploc bag, along with some extra larger zip ties. Next, lower the seat post and remove the lower cap and shove it all in there. If you ever need a zip tie or some extra strong tape, you know where to find it. You may be curious to know why I have a wire running across the seat post. Well, both my front and rear lights are powered by my dynamo hub, and I decided to install a second rear light closer to the saddle. It's connected to the main rear light in parallel, and the cable runs from underneath the bike, up the seat post, and into the rear light. I attached the second light to the telescopic seat post clamp using, you guessed it, a zip tie. The whole system doesn't affect the folding process in any way because I keep enough slack on the cables to allow me to fold and unfold the bike seamlessly. I can make a more detailed video about this mod in the future. Leave me a comment if that interests you. In the meantime, if you have any DIY experience, know that it can be done with some fiddling around, but the result is totally worth it. But since we're talking about zip ties, this next hack is one of my favorites. Have you ever found yourself struggling to reach the luggage block lever to release the front bag? I certainly have, but not anymore. Grab a large zip tie, loop it through the hole in the luggage block lever and around the head tube. Cut off the excess. Make sure the small plastic square is sitting against the lever, as it will prevent the zip tie from moving too much and scratching the paint. Now, use some other zip ties to make a small loop to stick your finger through, something like I did here. This will make it a lot easier to release the bags from the luggage block. Of course, there is a much nicer looking solution to this problem, but again, this is a hack. It's not expected to look good, but to work. Are you struggling to fit the tire into the rim because whenever you press the bead in on one side, it pops out on the other? Well, use one of those zip ties you have stored in your seat post to hold the tire against the rim while you work your way from the other side. It works every time. After you're done, just break the zip tie off by sticking the tire lever underneath it and rotating. If you want a more environmentally friendly hack, you can keep some reusable Velcro strip together with your tools and use that to hold the tire instead. This is an old hack known by many Brompton riders, but if you're new here, you will be surprised to know that one of the best bags for the Brompton costs nearly nothing, and it's called the Dimpa bag. You'll find it in the organizer section of IKEA, and it's a true lifesaver. It doesn't take up any space, and you can use it to carry the Brompton inside as luggage if you're not allowed to roll it in. Christine from the channel Chris by Bike uses a Dimpa bag to travel overseas, and she uses some pieces of cardboard to make the whole thing more secure for the bike. I'll leave a link to her channel down in the video description and also at the end of this video. You should definitely check out how she does it. Since we're talking about bags, I found it's a good idea to keep a small reusable bag attached to the bike at all times. It's useful for those occasions when you're caught off guard and end up having to buy something on your way home, but have no way to carry it. Or maybe your front bag just got too full to fit anything else. This small reusable bag from Whole Foods fits nicely on a handlebar without hitting the frame at the bottom. Since it's so close to center, it doesn't make steering any harder, and I barely notice it's even there. When I'm not using it, I keep it under the saddle, stuck in the gap between the rails and the seat. Are your elastic straps getting loose or losing their elasticity? Well, you may want to replace those soon, but in the meantime, you can get through by looping them around the rack once or even twice, depending on how bad it is. It doesn't restore their elasticity at all, but it does stop them from rattling when you're riding. Finally, if you have one of the older models of the Brompton with the shifters on top of the handlebar, flipping it around to remove the wheel will damage your shifters. In that case, you may want to keep the bike standing up like this. It allows you to remove both wheels without the handlebar touching the ground. Keep in mind that the bike is not that stable in this position, so be careful. Having the wheel extender will, again, make the bike more stable. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments section if you know any other hacks that were not mentioned here. If they're good, I'll feature them in a future video, and I'll make sure to give you the credit. For all of you, thank you for watching, and see you on the next one.